All right, so in this video, let's talk about the fact that XLOOKUP function returns a reference and not a value when you do a lookup and why that could be important. So everything we talk about here is gonna apply both to Excel and Google Sheets. And I'm gonna assume you already know how to do XLOOKUPs. If you don't, I'm gonna link to a video below in description where you can watch and understand how XLOOKUP works. But right now, let's just go ahead and do a quick example here. So if I, for example, go ahead and select a start year here, 2016, and I do an XLOOKUP, so I'm gonna search for this, comma, in this column, comma, and in this return column, I'm gonna get my results. Close parentheses, hit enter. See, I get 74,160, which is basically this matching value for this year. Now, the part that I wanna go over here is that when we do this XLOOKUP, what it does return is not the value of 74,160, but the reference to that cell. And the reference to the cell is B3. So essentially that XLOOKUP returns B3. And when we do equals B3, we will get that amount. Now, why is this important? So let's actually choose something here too. So imagine if I had to get the total from here through here, right? A basic sum function. So we go from B2 through B9 and we use the colon as our range syntax. And if I'd enter, that should get me the total of all of that. If I wanted this to start from, say, B3, I could have entered B3 here, right? So to start from B3, go to B9, I get my total. Now, if you remember, when we do this XLOOKUP, it doesn't return the value, it returns the reference. So this returns that B3, which means I could copy this without equal sign, go back to this formula and replace this B3 with this XLOOKUP as a starting point in this range. And with this, if I enter, this still works. Except that now, if I update this 2016 to say 2015, see this total updates. So now it's gonna start from here and go until here. And if I update it to 2017, again, this total updates automatically. So now instead of having a hard-coded starting point for a range, we actually have a lookup that finds the reference. And I could do the same with this part, right? Instead of hard-coding B9, we could have, let me just copy this formula and paste it here. And here I'm gonna change this B13 to this cell B14, which points to this year 2021. And that should get us the reference to this cell, right? So again, I could copy this, go back to here and replace this B9, paste the reference, hit enter. And now I'm gonna get the total between this and this, between 2017 and 2021. If I update this to 2022, this will update. If I go to 2020, see, it updates again. So now we can get, starting from here through here, basically using our references. And the same exact thing works the same way. If I copy this and paste this in Excel, see, the same thing. So we got our total, and if I play around with my start and end, that should give me the total. Just to check, let's make sure that we just do the total of these. So you should be able to see we get the same amount. So it works just fine. So there we go. We got a reference using XLOOKUP, and we use that reference in a different function. Now I did this example with sum function, but we could have used this in any other function, right? So to give you an example, like this lookup, if I just do this, this is gonna search for this year 2017 in this column, and it's going to go find this reference where this number 62,000 is, this one. Now, that's essentially like before. So if you imagine, if we do something like an offset function, offset accepts a reference as our first argument. So for example, I could say this cell, comma, and then how many rows I want to offset from this and how many columns I want to offset from this. So for example, if I do row offset 0 and column offset minus 1, see, essentially, that went the same row, one column left to this cell, 2017. And yet again, instead of having this before here, I could just go here, copy this XLOOKUP, go back, and instead of before, I'm going to do an XLOOKUP, which returns a reference, which means now my XLOOKUP, as you can see, it's going to find this year 2017 here, then it's going to return this reference to this before, and then our offset, it's going to take that before and go same row, one column left. Or maybe we want to go one row down and the same column or something like that, right? Like this, 1 and 0. So now it's going to go see 2017 was here and we did offset of one row. So it's going to go this next line, which should be the 68,000. There you have it. And again, if I update this to a different year, now 2020, again, our XLOOKUP is going to find a reference to this. Then our offset is going one down, so it takes to the cell. And this should also work, again, in Google Sheets the same exact way. So if I go back to my sheets, paste it here. Now, it's not the same number because this value is not the same. So in Excel, this was 2020. If I go back and update that to 2020, then we'll see how this, not this one, but this. See, it's going to go find 2020. That's going to return this 84,000 number reference. So again, it's not going to return 84,000. It returns B7, right? And from that B7, we offset one row down and we end up with this 71,000. So you can see that reference in action right here as well as in this formula. If you like my content, make sure you like and comment, subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.